What's up, guys? This is Mush here from Stop Hate Productions. I'm in GTA 5 doing the Kiff Long achievement. Now, what you got to do for this is you've got to achieve in a piece or not. Now, first thing you do, pull out your phone, go to the search bar, type in EP, make sure you put that hyphen there and then delete it. Just enter, go to the second link right down here, the Epsilon program. Click on that, open it up. Now, you want to evaluate your identity. Now you want to answer no to this first question, otherwise the achievement will not work, you will not get accepted, and then it doesn't matter what you answer for the rest of them. As you can see here, I just no, and it just spammed the yes button. Hit the get results, hit a process, and then it'll come up with this. Now I was reading through it all, and pay attention to that last close I'm about to highlight down there, but guys, once I finish screwing around, having a look around, this last one, right at the bottom there, that last paragraph, make sure you pay attention to that. It will give you some hints on how to do this achievement without having to watch the entire guide. It's a long guide, almost 20 minutes fucking long. It is a bitch of an achievement. It took me about 4 hours worth of recording just to do it for you guys to make it easier. Now you just exit out of that, and you'll have this pop up on your map, right up here. It's another Strangers and Freaks mission. But as you can probably tell, it's an Epsilon mission, so I'll just set the marker there and go there. Now here I am. I swapped cars because I blew the red one up. Yeah, here it is. I just sped it up for you guys just to make it a bit easier. Now it goes through a bit of dialogue.
Take me to my father, brother, uncle, Kifla.
No, peace, brother, Kifla.
And now you get the shit beaten out of you. Like, how else do you get initiated in anything? Just have the shit beaten out of you. They'll pick you up, drop you in the middle of the desert. His voiceover recur.
Come to Vinewood for the real truth, but first there'll be $500, please. Give long be praised.
So there it is, I'll tell you how much you gotta spend. Now, you usually get an email. I actually didn't because I'd finished the game, so I don't get emails for extra missions, stuff like that. So you just go on the internet again. Type in EP again, go to the Epsilon page. Now you don't have to worry about putting the hyphen in that time, guys. You scroll down and make a donation right there. Now you click on it, donate the $500. And now it's just a waiting game. You've got to wait for a very long fucking time, guys. I had to wait probably about half hour to an hour for that one mission to pop up. It'll pop up right there, back in downtown Vinewood. It's this building right here. You just walk inside.
Hello?
I'll speed this up for you guys so you, there's not many spoilers and make it a bit faster. This whole dialogue will happen.
You are ready,
so yeah,
but you are not ready.
Melt into nothingness if she just told you.
The truth is incredible if you're capable of understanding it. Better even press. We will send you an incredible education tool that will help you to unlock the secrets of existence. How about the dollars?
$5,000.
What price would you put on
now, guys, I haven't tried this with Trevor, but Franklin, it will not let Franklin do it, so it has to be Michael or Trevor. I'll check with Trevor right now, actually, because I've got the game open. I don't know if it'll actually alert him, though. Yeah, no, it's only Michael. So there you go, guys. You have to be Michael for this. Now here you've got to donate $5,000. It's the same place for $500. Only you go $5,000 this time. Now the next one here. I'll just speed through this because I hate the cutscenes and I don't really want to ruin anything for you guys. Now the only reason I actually recorded these and didn't skip them was for you guys, in case you actually wanted to see what you had to do during the mission. Now here you get told to get certain cars. San Andreas Super Autos. Southern San Andreas Super Autos. Easiest place to get them. You've got to get the Serrano, Benefactor Serrano. It doesn't matter what color. Now guys, you will need a bit of money for this achievement, which is why it's probably best to do it after you finish the game. The Serrano. Just scroll down a little more. gonna need the Enos Super Diamond. Enos Super Diamond, the Enos, I don't know. This is where you're gonna find the tornado. I believe you also need a Vacca, which you can also get off that site. If not, just go to Legendary Motorsports and put them in your garage and take them out that way. Now yeah, so I've got the cops on me here, because I was a bit of an idiot and stole the bike. But no, once the cops are gone, you just take the Enos, not the Enos, the tornado. Now here, the last one, the hardest one to find for me, was the Dinka Double T. It's a bike. As you can see there, I just sniped a couple of guys off bikes thinking they were the bikes I needed. That one I sniped the first time wasn't it. That guy was. Now you can see there's a couple of bikes drove past me. Do not mistake them. The Dinka Double T looks exactly like this one. Now once you do that, you fall off the bike I just did, being a fucking retard. Get back on it. And you take it up to where the Epsilon program symbol is.
You got lucky, buddy.
I'll lose myself up here pretty fast. I know where it is already, so I can get up there without a waypoint. You guys, you'll learn where it is after the first or second car. As you can see, I'm fucking horrible driving in this game. No, I'm just going to hide in here. The Epsilon program one is the next house over. I just need to get rid of the cops. I usually don't listen to the radio, but I couldn't be bothered fucking around with it. There we go. Turn it off. Now I'm just going to sit here and do a bit of burnout. Waiting for the cops to disappear. Waiting for the wanted level to disappear. Should be just about done. Hey guys, you can write anything you want with the burnout. Just bear in mind it does disappear after a while. So it's a funny way to say hi to your friends, stuff like that. Now you just drive down to the Epsilon sign just here. And this is the last vehicle I needed to get in here. So you just exit the vehicle, walk outside, and you'll get a mission passed in a second here. There it is, vehicle delivered.
Good boy.
Mission passed. Now the next mission, you've got to come up. It'll pop up on your map. It's out of town in Lane County, I think it was. Now you go through this dialogue with Jimmy Boston. So I've sped this up because it took me about half hour just to do this one bit. I've cut it down to about 5 minutes for you guys. Now you just search around. When the device goes blue, that's when you do it. So as you can see, it's getting bluer and bluer and faster, and then I lost it. Lost it again. Lost it. There it is. There's a fucking TV. So you keep searching. Now there's usually three, but there is also, you get a gold medal if you go straight to where the third item is, but you'll see where I am in a second. Now we're just cutting through this. I've got it at 350% speed, I believe I had it. And it still took me a while to get through it.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves here. So this is it, right?
Yep, you'll get another dial. Yeah, it's 350% speed. So you guys can see where all the items are. Or if you just want to be smart, go for the last one. Just to be a bitch, it's okay.
Okay, fine then, no flashing bots. Reveal the great truth to me.
It's... Oh, I lost it. And there it is. I lose it for a second there, and just find it again. It's a boot. A motherfucking boot. As you can see, you only get a bronze medal for that one. To get the gold medal, all you've got to do is find it without using the device. Now, she tells you you need to donate $10,000. Just go to the donation page. Two lots of 5,000. I think I do three here, because I didn't know whether it worked or not. But that's okay, because I've got about $1 million coming in every week. So the next one's down here in Vinewood yet again. You find Marnie, or whatever the hell her name is, next to a wall. She'll be drawing. Now, you've got to buy the attire, which is right here on the page. You just buy the robes. It's $25,000. As I said, guys, you're going to need a lot of money for this one. I think it cost me about 5 million. Yeah, around about 5 million just to do everything. As you can see there, it's saying I've already got the roads. Now I just got to wait for the fucking things to be delivered. I'll cut to it. There it is. The email saying they're delivered. Just go into your wardrobe and equip the robes, which is right here. Now it's just in normal outfits. It should be at the very bottom. They're pale blue. Now you got to spend 10 cumulative days in them. But what you can do is you can go off and do missions, stuff like that. Just don't do any major heists because it changes your clothes and you'll have to come back and put them back on again. Either that or you can just sleep continuously because it advances time by 6 hours. Now this one's the next one. You gotta get into the plane and fly to Jimmy Boston. Now I've just sped this up because it's an absolute bitch. While I was flying, I hate flying. Especially in GTA 5, I mean, that wind just throws me off every time. As you can see here, I'm circling around, coming down from the landing. Now guys, don't get too close to Jimmy because you will fail it. I failed it just there, so I've had to do it again, which is why it's gone clear, it's raining. I failed it, so I've just cut it out and put it back in. Now you just pull up on the plane, get out, and you can walk straight over to Jimmy Boston.
What are you doing, bro?
There he is right there.
Kiflam,
now
bro.
What he'll do is Kiflam. Do this
money?
Whole
Kiflam.
Cool.
Dialogue thing. Kiflam, 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 blah, blah, blah.
Nice.
There's
you're
the plane.
Almost a thesis of truth, bro. Nearly
there you
there.
Go, he said you're almost the thesis
cost a little
of
time
truth.
And effort.
I think there's maybe
2-3
more missions.
7,000 places all over.
As with the Epsilon program before, you actually get the achievement.
You know, Chris and I sometimes watch porn together in the nude. Just to prove we don't get turned on by it. Pretty awesome. Anyway,
well, there you go.
Kiflam, man.
Watching porn in
latest.
The nude with another dude.
Kiflam.
Oh!
That's totally not gay.
Chris says, if you're ready, there's a tree of truth. And he'll arrange a map, but it's kind of expensive to reach this level of existence. It'll need quite a bit of money.
Said, it's kind of expensive.
Someone will mail
now,
you,
now, guys, I've spent
mind
probably
if I take
about
the plane?
2 million already.
Kiflam.
Just on all the cars and everything you need to get. It is an absolute bitch of an achievement. Which is why, again, I must stress, guys, do it at the end of the game, after you finish the last mission. No spoilers. Now, what you've got to do is go to the next one, you go through a bit of a dialogue, and then you've got to run through the desert for 5 miles or 8 kilometers. Now, I've sped this up to 1,000%. Here it is, 1,000%. I'm just running around in a circle. It takes forever. Now you could just wander through the desert, but I just started doing circle work because my car was right there. It's pretty easy to get back in my car and take off. Running around in circles, just keep going around and around and around and around in circles. Now even at 1,000%, this is going to be at least 2 minutes worth of work here. 2 or 3 minutes. Now, while you're doing this, guys, you cannot leave Michael while he's in the desert. Otherwise, he will just walk away. I left him the first time I done it, and I ended up back in Franklin's fucking body. I went back to Franklin, and jumped back into Michael. He's back at home, being an asshole. As you can see there, I just popped up my, I had a friend join me, so I just popped up my thing, and just checked who he was. Turns out he's one of our other recorders, Jamie. Very unprofessional. So I'm just running around and around and around and around and around in circles, checking my messages. As you can see there, just above your map, you'll get a Snapchat type thing, a fucking pop-up, saying how far you've gone. At that time, I was 3.1 miles. 3.2, 3.3, and this is at 1,000% speed, guys. 1,000%. Now while you're doing this, all you'll hear Michael say is Kiflom, Kiflom, Kiflom. You get a phone call from someone saying you've only got one more mile to go. I think it's Chris that gives you the phone call. Either Chris or Marnie, because they're the main contacts in this. Chris, Marnie, and Jimmy. Now guys, remember that was 1000% speed to do all that. I'm still going. Here you go, phone call.
Am I finished?
No.
This is Chris.
Your journey is just beginning. Have you cast off the cane? Have you observed your inefficiencies?
I guess so.
Then they no longer exist. You are ready.
Ready for what?
To make another investment in yourself. Bring a generous tithe to the center in Vinewood, and I will personally receive you.
And as he said, he will personally receive me. Now, I'm just running around here. I had a few more things to do up here. I was just getting the last load of scrap from over this direction, so I thought I'd do it as Michael. Now there's another cutscene there, guys. Now you just get into this baby blue car. Just follow them. Now you've got one or two options here. Either you can leave the car there, let them take the money, or you can kill them all and get away with a good 2.1 million. Now I failed this 4 times because I'd never worked out how to fucking get out of there. I'd always get killed by the chopper. This time I decide to back the car up. It tells me to exit the car. I exit the car.
Good work.
They'll go on a little spiel. So I just pull out a fucking minigun and fuck everyone up. It's good that you're doing this as Michael because he's got the slow motion. Slow time while you're on foot. Now try and be careful not to hit your own car. If you hit that car, you're gonna lose it. Mission failed. As you can see there, that chopper's about to take off. There it goes, it just took off for no reason, and it blows up. I've got 2 more guys to take out on foot. That guy, and I don't even worry about that guy, I just get back in the car and take off. Now you get the cops on you here, and you'll get the security on you as well. What you do, hide from the cops and kill the security. You've got to make sure to kill the security, otherwise you won't get the achievement pop, which is right there. Kiflom, brother, brother. You've completed your path, the Epsilon program, and achieved inner peace. Now, I killed the guys. Drop us a like and subscribe for more guys. Mush out.